Going on, guys. JT here. Just wanted to say, hope y'all like the series now. If you do, make sure you hit the like button. If you want to see more of it, make sure you hit the subscribe button. I'll talk to y'all later.
Here's your new desk, kid. You're on traffic. The hot sheet is posted here, next to the map.
What's his problem?
That's Biggs. He's an institution.
So this is what all the fuss is about. Why couldn't they build a freeway that goes past my place?
They haven't even approved the money yet, kid. The bond issue won't be till December. It'll be years before any of this will happen. Here's your new partner, Stefan Berkowski.
I've heard all about you, Phelps. You go easy on me and let me earn the odd citation, and maybe we'll get along fine.
I'm here to learn, Detective.
Oh, he's an intense one, isn't he, Mel?
He's intense.
The newly minted detective here, Cole Phelps.
Hi, Phelps. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I could spend a little time basking in reflected glory, make a change from busting hookers and dope fiends.
Who was that, Commander?
Roy Earle, chief detective and advice.
Do they all dress like movie stars?
Well, Roy is a movie star. And the whole of the seedy side of L.A. is his audience.
What is that supposed to mean?
Stick with me, kid. You'll find out.
And now some housekeeping. Warm Central Division welcome for Detective Cole Phelps. Some of you guys may know Phelps. He's the cop who broke the jewelry store murder. Stand up and take a bow, Phelps.
If it's all right with you,
that's
sir.
That's an order, Phelps.
Ooh.
Shh, quiet, everybody.
Phelps is one of only two serving LAPD officers who received the Silver Star during the war. You really gave it those lousy Japanese, eh, Phelps?
I did my best, Captain.
Why, you war hero is always so modest. I've partnered Phelps with everybody's favorite Pole, Stefan Bukowski.
Hope you like work, kid.
Bukowski sure as hell doesn't.
Well, that's why we have partners, right?
Okay, can it, guys. Stick with Bukowski. He's a good cop. He knows traffic inside and out. I'm going to start you out with one case. You do okay, I'll give you a couple more. You screw up, you'll be rousting vagrants and running license plates. Now get down to the P.E. Freight Depot, 6th and Alameda. A patrolman called in a suspicious vehicle. Signs of foul play. See what you can find out.
Come on, Phelps.
I want to make homicide. You know you made it if you get that guy.
You're wasting time. Get out of here.
They really pushed you through quick, didn't they? 6 years on patrol before I got this desk. You were here in 5 minutes.
What do you want me to say? I didn't ask for any favors.
Well, you don't see that every day.
Mary says I'll
say. Son, you're a couple of slates short of a full room.
That's the guy.
You know this place?
I hear he's an honest guy.
Sure. Near the old gasworks and signal depot in the warehouse district. I'll direct. So, tell me a little about yourself, Phelps. Are we friends now, Bukowski? We have to work together. Don't be so touchy. Grew up in San Francisco. My father was in shipping. Went to college at Stanford. Did 2 years ROTC before Reno CS at Camp Elliott. Shipped out in early 45 as a first lieutenant. Fought in the opening column. Was wounded, took back home. Did a year on the beat, now I'm here. So you won the Silver Star. I don't want to talk about it. Now let me get this straight. You single-handedly killed 40 Japs on this hill in Okinawa. No, you were up there all night, draped in the flag, knife between your teeth, gun at the ready, finished? The Emperor Hirohito himself leading the charge against you.
I did my part, Bukowski. What did you do?
I kept the streets of L.A. safe for the people.
Yeah. Now I get it. Unfit for service.
Now fuck you, Phelps. I earned a bravery citation during the Zooter riots.
Sounds like you had it rough.
I did my job.
No one is saying you didn't.
I did 6 years as a patrolman. That's the third time you've told me.
That you, Bukowski? Go on through. Parking lot straight ahead.
I need to get back to work, officer.
The detectives are here now. You repeat to them what you told me.
I did the right thing by calling this in. I'm just a working stiff.
Just give them your story and you'll be all right.
This is your first case, Phelps. It's okay to admit it if you're stumped. If you don't know what to do next, just come talk to me and we'll see what we can figure out.
Thanks, Stefan. You're okay.
I'm Officer Hart.
Phelps, traffic. What have you got?
Abandoned car, probably stolen. The solid citizen is Nate Wilkie. He called it in.
What gives with the coroner?
There's blood all over the interior. Someone's copped the full Broderick, but no stiff as yet.
We have an owner for the car?
The car is registered to an Adrian Black, just north of Bunker Hill.
All right, we'll take a look around.
I'll keep Mr. Wilkie talking, but don't make him wait too long. He's the restless type.
Nice day for it.
How long you gonna keep me here, sir?
I better get back to work, sir.
How's the world looking?
Doc? Detective Phelps. What have we got?
A lot of blood for a blunt force injury. Victim must be in a very bad way.
Any sign of the guy?
Not unless he's in the trunk of the car.
Don't think this is anything.
Mr. F. Morgan picked up a live pig yesterday? Victim looks to have lost a lot of blood.
How's life treating you?
That's because they got two more jobs in Westlake Park and one up in Hollywood Hills.
Not everything here is going to be relevant.
Stencil glasses. Home repaired by the look of it. Happier times, I guess. Married. Married. Sounds like an average guy. What was he doing out here?
Hey, Flatfoot, you're looking to get rid of that old crate? I'll give you a nickel for it.
Thank you.
Sir, I'm Detective Phelps.
Name's Nate Wilkie.
You found the vehicle?
Sure. Saw it just sitting there. Strange place to be parking your car. Figured I'd better take a look. And then I saw all the blood. So I called the police.
Mind if I ask what you were doing out here?
Well, I work for the railway. I was on my way out to the switch and reckon I'd take a shortcut.
Did you see anybody else in the yard? Maybe somebody hanging around the car?
Nope. I hadn't seen a soul all day till you boys turned up.
Do you know Adrian Black, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. That ain't a name I'm familiar with.
You ever seen the car before?
Funny enough, I did. A couple of nights ago, it was over there in the parking lot. I know most of the cars are parked here regularly, so it kind of stood out.
The wallet by the car. Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
Do you want the patrolman to hold you down while we turn out your pockets, Mr. Wilkie?
Maybe I checked inside that wallet. Not that I was gonna steal anything. Maybe I took a look. But there weren't no money in there. Not even change.
We found a steel pipe with blood on it near the car. Do you know anything about it, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. I went straight for the law when I saw the car was full of blood.
When you saw the blood, was it wet, bright red, or darker like it is now?
Darker, I'd say. Looked dry already.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Wilkie. We'll contact your employer if we need anything more from you.
If you have to, I guess. I can't really spend no more time over this.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps. You're done here. We'll head over there now.
You know the way. You can drive.
So, where do you want to go? Let's go introduce ourselves. You talk to her, Phelps. I'm no good at this shoulder to cry on stuff.
Just a minute.
LAPD, Mrs. Black. May we come in? We have some bad news, and we'd rather discuss this in private.
I'm Margaret Black. We can discuss this in the living room. Please come in.
Your husband drives a blue Lincoln, Mrs. Black?
That's correct.
The car has been found abandoned, and I'm afraid there are signs of foul play.
I knew something was wrong when he didn't come home.
We believe your husband may be injured. We found a pipe on the scene with blood on it.
Oh, no! My poor Adrian!
Does the name Instaheat mean anything to you, ma'am?
Yes, it does. We've just had a new water heater installed.
Whereabouts, Mrs. Black?
Just outside the kitchen window, at the side of the house.
I'd like you to try and stay calm and remember everything that you can about last night. My partner and I are going to take a look around. When you're ready, we're going to have some more questions for you. Is that okay?
Of course, officer. Anything to help secure my husband's safety.
Well, let's check the place out. Come on.
Circumstantial. Seems irrelevant.
Have a good look around. There's got to be something in here to go on.
And a suitcase gone missing. Someone couldn't wait to get out of this house. This must be Adrian's. Stencil. So the glasses are a match. Separate bedrooms, separate pictures. What gives here? To my Adrian. This thing gets more and more interesting. Kavanaugh's. So who brought this home? Maybe Adrian was a patron. R and I should have an address.
Down, make yourself comfortable. So, you're a friend of Courtney's?
Yes, doctor.
He seems very concerned about you.
I have these visions, these blinding visions. I can't get them out of my head. My skull, it feels like it's in a vice.
I'm going to give you something to calm your nerves. I want to take you on a journey. Journey back. I want you to remember the good things about your past. Occasions that made you laugh. Times that made you smile.
This was only recently installed.
not 2 days ago.
Maybe it's time we took a look around outside.
Giving me anything to go on.
Leaving the thing half finished. That can't be right. The pipe missing from Mr. Black's heater is the same one that killed him. Huh. Seems like the assailant is a little closer to home. Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address on a Kavanaugh's bar.
Certainly, Detective. One moment. Kavanaugh's bar, corner of Aliso and Hewitt, south side of Union Station.
Thanks, ma'am.
I'm all right now, detectives.
We found a receipt in the trunk of your husband's car for a live pig. This receipt was made out to an F. Morgan.
A pig? Adrian runs a tool business. That would be Frank Morgan. God knows what he's up to.
What makes you say that about Morgan, ma'am?
He's the foreman at my husband's plant. Very shady character. I've told Adrian he needs to keep his distance from the staff. They're always out drinking together.
Was your husband wearing his glasses when he left here yesterday?
Yes, he just bought a new pair.
So you disposed of the new pair after you killed your husband? You made a mistake in leaving the old pair behind.
I never did! How can you be so heartless, throwing around accusations at a time like this?
Did your husband tell you where he was going last night?
All he said was he was gonna meet Frank for a drink.
So nothing out of the usual, then?
Well, he came home early from work. He never comes home early. And he went out early, too. He normally never leaves for the bar till about 7.
Tell us about the photo of Adrian in the bedroom.
What is there to tell? It's from his most recent business trip to Seattle.
There's plenty to tell. You just won't tell it. You're lying about the photograph, Mrs. Black.
You're incredibly rude and insensitive. But I guess you know that. I've told you what I know about the picture.
What about Nicole, Mrs. Black? Was your husband going to leave you for her?
I've seen the photo frame. He thinks I'm stupid. But women sense these things. I don't know if he intended to leave me or if it was just a fling. God only knows. I only want to know that he's safe.
Your husband frequents Kavanaugh's bar?
How did you know that? Adrian practically lives there after work.
So Adrian spends a lot of time there?
Up until recently, he's been away in Seattle a lot on business.
I think you should come clean with us, Mrs. Black. Your husband is missing, and after our search, I'm willing to call the circumstances suspicious. Can you account for your movements last night?
You're not accusing me, are you? What an awful thing to say. I was here all night, of course, waiting for Adrian to come home.
Is there anyone who can vouch for that?
Well, no. I was here alone. I cooked Adrian's dinner and waited, but he never came home.
We'll keep you informed, Mrs. Black.
Please do, Detective.